Okay, we have to make a group decision. We have we're running late. We have a short break on the schedule, but would you guys like to just keep going and so we can hopefully finish up before midnight? So next we have Judy Arnold. She's the supervisor for the 5th district, and her title is Fun and Fundraising. I think fundraising is one of the hardest things that we all have to do. So anyway, hopefully Judy can give us some really great ideas.
Thank you.
So how many of you here are running, there it went, are running for the first time? Okay. Oh, hi, Katie. And, okay, how many incumbents are running for some, I mean, it can be for a different office, but that you've run before, okay? And how many have or are planning to fund your own campaign? Okay, okay. Well, I subscribe to the theory that every candidate should raise money. And why? Because I think that asking for money hones your message and gives you confidence, as well as giving, as well as funding your campaign. When I ran for city council, I made a list of everyone. That was the first time I had run for anything. I made a list of everyone I knew, starting with family, then friends, and I contacted them, because that was the easy part. Then the harder part, I wrote out, then I had to go to the next level of acquaintances or business colleagues. And so I wrote out a script for myself, and it was, well, I was running against three entrenched incumbents for the city council. And when you're running against an incumbent, your message really has to be why you would be better in this job than the incumbent has been. It's much easier to run for an office where everyone is fresh and they're running for the same, they're all running for the first time. So when I was running for city council, there was a lot of furor on the council over something called Street Gate in Novato, and city council members were walking out of the meeting and were appearing on the press and criticizing each other. So my message on the phone was, hi, this is Judy Arnold. I'm running for Novato City Council because I believe that the current council is too busy feuding to take care of city business. They need adult supervision. I'm asking you to help me accomplish this, and I'm asking you to help me by contributing. And then my literature fit with that, and my walk piece was a little boy in like his dad's clothes that looked huge, and it said, you know, the council needs adult supervision, and I'll bring it. And so humor again, humor is good in that. When you start making phone calls after you've got your family, the first call's the hardest one to make, and I have seen candidates that will think of a million excuses not to sit down and phone and call for money. I mean, well, I know, but I've got to return these phone calls because I might get this endorsement. Well, I have to do this. And I've seen campaign managers just take them by the hand, sit down with them, and sit there, dial the phone and hand it to them because they're so afraid to make those calls because it's hard. When I started phoning for money for city council, a great thing happened, and sometimes you're surprised. People are going to say no. They're going to say, you know, no, I just can't do it. Or, you know, I think the current council's doing doing a good job. But I called one businessman, and I said, I'm running. And then he said, how much do you want? And that's a new thing, because that, oh, God. So I said $1,000. And he said, you know what, because this is your first call, I'm going to give you $2,000. Well, my God, you feel so great after that then you just start calling for more and more. And so pretty soon, it gets to be kind of enjoyable. But the important thing also is if you don't have the confidence to say to someone, I want you to invest in me because I think I'm worth it, because I'm going to do a good job for you, then, you know, you really maybe aren't the candidate you should be. And that's why I think, you know, people I know get upset at a lot of spending money in campaigns and campaign reform, but I think it's part of the whole process in this country of serving the people and asking them to join you in serving them and being accountable to the people. Campaigns really, here's another thing that was surprising to me. Campaigns don't stop for you. I remember when I was pregnant with my first baby, and one day it occurred to me, the only way I'm going to get through this is to go through it. And that was terrifying for a while. Well, campaigns are like that. They don't stop because you just were afraid to make a few calls. They don't stop. The mail, if your mail doesn't arrive the day the absentee ballots hit, you're not going to hit the absentee ballots. And when for absentee ballots, all the seniors vote on the first day the absentees come. The rest of them wait about 3 weeks. So you've missed all the seniors. And just because you were busy or because, well, I don't have the money, you lost it. So you need to really understand and budget and see that you have a timeline, which I know Dottie talked about, where I'm going to need this money for this mailer to send out. If you were brave enough to throw your hat in the ring, because that's a big decision, then you're going to have to be brave enough to ask for money and to not be obnoxious about it, because I have seen some candidates that just have no sense of when to ask for money or how to ask for money. But, you know, you really are, and you should be able to do this. You'll be amazed at how brazen you can get, too. Once you start doing it and people start giving you money, there was a man, this is when I was running for city council, and he was pretty conservative and he was really grumpy, but, you know, he could give money. So I called him and I said, you know, I'm running for city council and I would really like your support, and I'd like a contribution from you. And he said, you work for that communist John Burton. Do you think I would ever give you any money? And so then I started telling him, well, look, you know, yeah, I did. But here's what I'm doing, and here's how important I think it is for businesses. I'm really trying to bring in some businesses to Novato, and here's what I'm going to try to do. I called him back and said, so did you decide that you're going to contribute to my campaign? About 3 days later, I got a check from him for $25. And so I called him up. I said, you know what? Thank you so much. I got your check. I don't want to embarrass you by having this show up on my FPPC report. You forgot to add 2 zeros. He didn't add 2 zeros. But, you know, he since has become a big supporter. And so it's just, you know, don't let this be a barrier to you. Just go out there and say who you are and what you're going to do and why it's important for people to contribute and be a part of your campaign. Make them a part of your campaign. Carve out each day to make phone calls. That's going to be hard because you can think of a million reasons why you shouldn't sit down and make calls. I've got to go walk a precinct. I have to go cram for this a candidate's night. No, say from 2 to 4 or from 4 to 6 or 6 to 7, I'm going to make calls. And leave messages and keep track and then call back. And then once they say, yes, all right, I'm going to send you $100, send a letter thanking them with a remit envelope in so that they'll be, and then follow up if they haven't sent it. And, you know, I really believe that raising money strengthens you as far as serving in office, because if you can raise money for your campaign, enough to, and I've been able to raise, you know, money that really has been able to fund, you know, all the three campaigns that I've run. After you do this, not much else is going to intimidate you, unless it's a hit piece, and that's a session for another time. So thanks. If you haven't, you don't have questions.
Judy.
Yes.
I have
yes.
A question.
Yes. Good. Fine. Sure.
How did your success as a fundraiser compare with the Barack Obama approach? Was there any? Were you aware of any similarity, since he's kind of like the he's the poster child for
raising money?
Yeah. Were there any elements of what you did that you were aware
Well, he did the internet. I didn't do that so much. I do now. I will now in 2014. But mine was really just the personal touch. I would just call and meet with people, and Barack couldn't do that. He had to send out messages. Sometimes you can send out frantic messages, and I know Nancy Pelosi did over this weekend. If you would just give $3, we're going to be able to reach our goal. I really didn't do that because I don't think you need to so much in a local race. What you can send out messages on the internet or emails and say, please, we need you to do this. But in the three races I was in, the people were so involved in the campaign that we didn't really need to do that. We might need to in the future. Yeah. Did I see another hand? Yes. No, you just say who you are and why you're running in two sentences and why you need them to contribute. And then in your mind have a number in case they say, how much do you want? I don't think you're running for assembly, so there are quotas. I mean, you have limits, yeah. Yeah, we didn't have limits when I ran for city council. They do now, $400, and we don't for the county. Okay? Okay, yes.
How much money do you need to raise?
For city council? When I ran for city council, there were five of us in the race, and three of them were very entrenched incumbents. And I think that I raised over $50,000, which is high for a city council race. When I ran for supervisor, we had a primary and a general, and both of those races came to over $250,000. Yeah. You're welcome. Thank you. Okay, thanks, Barbara. You're welcome. Yeah, you're welcome.